Kids. If you look at the Choice Media website, we have the 4 million kids to begin their test of Common Core exams this week, and we'll have a little more on that later. In fact, we've seen that Mark has written some to some extent about Common Core and wanted to show you just a couple things. This is a piece he penned in July of 2013, Common Core versus Great Literature, posing the, I guess, the structure of that title as if there is a choice. Which do you want? Do you want Common Core or Great Literature? And then also this piece was from this month. He writes, Mark Bauerlein writes, why we all have a stake in the Common Core standards. And so we're going to get to a little more of that in a bit, Mark, but tell us, I guess, where you're coming from on these pieces and why do we all have a stake in the Common Core standards?
Well, my position on Common Core is that I think the standards overall have some strengths, and I'm coming at it mostly from high school because I teach in college. I'm at the freshman year for the most part. So I'm seeing students 3 months after they've graduated from high school, and I'm in an English department. And so I get a nice glimpse of what students at a fairly selective institution are doing in their last 3 years, we'll say, of high school reading. And what I find is that their reading is all over the place. There is very little uniformity that you can count on. There's only one book that you can mention that every single student has read so far. It's not the Bible. It is not Huck Finn. It's not The Great Gatsby. It's Harry Potter. this is the common reading, the common book in their lives now. And I think Common Core tries to address that with a few of the standards that do highlight some strong literature. There's one standard for grade 11 and 12 literature reading that has students demonstrate knowledge of foundational works of 18th, 19th, and early 20th century literature. They don't specify what those are. The problem is that when we get to the actual lesson plans and modules that are created, when the curriculum developers get a hold of the standards, and then when the test developers, which is what we're going to get this week, start administering the test, what are we going to see? And in the first article that you mentioned, I noticed that very few of the curriculum materials that I've seen do have a strong literary and just strong classic text component.
So explain how that could be, Mark. You've got, if you say this, you like the standards, but you don't like the curriculum or the various curricula developed around them. Allegedly, the curricula being back driven by the assessments. Is that the point of view? How is it that the textbooks aren't so good then? Where did it go wrong?
Right now, until the tests really come out, it's going to be back-driven mostly by the standards, or at least it's supposed to be. But I'll tell you what a leading educator said to me a while back when I mentioned that standard that I just cited about knowledge of foundational works of literature. And I said, how are they going to work those into the curriculum? That sounds like a full year course of American literature. How are they going to work that into the tests? And he said, they won't. They'll just ignore it. So this is the issue here with getting the curricular materials genuinely aligned with the standards and then getting the tests genuinely assessing what appears in the standards. And the fact is we're going to get people picking and choosing. They're going to go where the strengths are, and the standards are big enough so that you can get pick and choose, and you can be selective, and you can go with what you're already familiar with.
I got to tell you, this is a very different critique of Common Core than we're used to, because you describe uniformity as a virtue. Many of the Common Core critics consider uniformity something to be avoided, something to be feared, that it actually kills innovation, uniformity. Your critique is that there's just too many people are doing their own thing here, and there's not enough uniformity, right?
Well, I do, and I'm in one of the softer subjects. I'm in English, and I believe that having a core body of knowledge going way back into traditions, and that can go back into English literature all the way back to Shakespeare, it can go back American literature all the way to Ben Franklin and the Puritans, I think that's an important thing,
all right.
And that all students should have it.